Okay, final topic of the day, my Malkin's moments. I have a lot of football moments, obviously. So start with my number one Malkin's moment. Tom Brady passed Drew Brees to become the NFL's leading passer, all-time leader in most passing yards, and he surpassed Drew Brees' mark of 80,358 to become the NFL's all-time leading passer. He entered Sunday just needing 68 yards. He surpassed that on a 28-yard reception to Mike Evans. Tom Brady, it's no surprise that he was going to pass Drew Brees, but it was fitting that the venue in which he ended up surpassing that mark and eclipsing Brees, it was only fitting that it would take place against the Patriots in Foxborough at Gillette Stadium, where he has left an indelible mark on the organization and on the NFL. So it was only right that that would happen on that field. And obviously he passed Drew Brees last year for most touchdowns in the NFL, so not a surprise there. Shout out to Andy Reid for becoming the first NFL coach ever to win at least 100 games with two different franchises. He hit that mark with the Philadelphia Eagles and now with the Kansas City Chiefs. He's just been a legendary head coach. His offensive system has worked everywhere. He's a player's coach. He's developed and built such great chemistry and rapport with the players everywhere he goes. You seldomly hear about players that didn't love playing for Andy Reid. And it's not surprising that he was able to attain such great success over two decades of coaching and over 100 wins with two different organizations. A lot of coaches struggle to win 50 games with one organization, let alone 100 with two. Big shout out to Andy Reid. Aaron Rodgers tied Dan Marino for six most passing touchdowns in NFL history. In fact, he just hit his 420th career passing touchdown. He just actually not only tied him, but passed him for sixth on the list as the Packers ended up beating the Steelers 27-17. So Aaron Rodgers, he's like 37, 38. He's still moving up the chains. He most likely won't catch, you know, Brady or Brees, but still playing long enough where he could probably scoot into the top four. Sam Darnold, this is an interesting Malkin's moment, but I wanted to give him a shout out. He became the first quarterback with at least five rushing touchdowns through the first four games of the season ever. It's hard to fathom given you've had the Michael Vicks and you've had the Lamar Jacksons and the Russell Wilsons and the Kyler Murrays. Sam Darnold, of all people, leads the NFL. And for much of this year, he was the leading touchdown rusher in the NFL for any position, let alone a quarterback. Running backs, doesn't matter. Interesting, kind of weird stat, but want to give him a shout out. A couple more. Trayvon Diggs became the first Dallas player to have at least one interception in each of his first four games since the 1970 merger. Again, Trayvon Diggs, the cornerback out of Alabama, has been sensational. He leads the NFL with five interceptions on the season, and he's had at least one interception in every single game, and is a big reason why this Dallas Cowboys defense is much improved, a big reason why they're 3-1 on the year is because of his tremendous play. Final two, Russell Wilson, quarterback for the Seattle Seahawks, former quarterback for NC State, and of course, my alma mater, Wisconsin, collected his 100th win of his career. But this is what's impressive. No quarterback in NFL history has got to 100 career wins faster than Russell Wilson. So he's the fastest quarterback to reach 100 wins. That's how special he's been. That's how special the type of career he's had. He's never had a losing season as a starting quarterback. Never. It's amazing. Even that includes even his rookie year when he was drafted out of the third round. So impressive start for him. And then finally, Vladimir Guerrero Jr., the talented slugger for the Toronto Blue Jays. It's a shame that we didn't get a chance to see him in the postseason. He's been absolutely sensational. He just passed Eddie Matthews for the most home runs in a season by a player under 22 years of age. He hit his 48th home run of the season. Again, the Blue Jays came one game short behind the Yankees and the Red Sox from making the wild card in the AL. And it's a shame we don't get a chance to see this guy, that we're going to have to wait another year to see if maybe the Blue Jays can get into the postseason. He's had one of the historically great seasons of all time in baseball. So big shout out to him. Well, that'll do it for us here on Morning Joe. Thank you so much for joining me every single Monday and Wednesday morning, 11 a.m. to 12 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, 10 to 11 Central, and 8 to 9 a.m. Pacific. Make sure to subscribe to my YouTube page, Morning Joe with Jonah Malkin. Follow me at Jonah Malkin on Twitter or at morning_Joe_Instagram, JMalk97, TikTok, Jonah Malkin. Make sure to subscribe, like, comment, all that jazz. And as always, have a lovely rest of your morning.